Hello students, today I am going to explain forced due to the multiple charges by using superposition principle or principle of superposition. So what is a superposition principle statement? It is explaining if more than two charges are present in a space, then net force acting on any charge is the vector sum of electrical forces acting on it individually due to the other charges. Means what is the meaning of these sentences? If number of charges in a given place present in a given place, then net force acting on any one charge is vector sum of electrical forces acting on it individually. So what is the meaning? It is indicating if F is a force acting on Q, then total force is equal to F1 bar, F2 bar plus F3 bar up to and so on Fn. Means multiple charges is present there, then force acting on charge Q is equal to is the vector sum of all the charges present in a given space. So let us prove that. So for this I am considering charge Q is placed at O and Q1 is placed here, and at the same time Q2 is placed here and Q3 is placed here. So let us give the names. This is A, this is B, this is C. So in between these the vector position vector is R1, and from Q and Q2 is R2, and at the same time Q and Q3 is R3. So let us take the displacement and vector in the direction of AO, that is R1 cap, and here also this is R2 cap, and this is R3 cap. This is the displacement vector. Means when we go from Q1 to Q, then the displacement vector is R1 cap. This is a unit vector we are taking. So these two are like charges, no? Then force will be acting in this direction, that is F1, in the direction of AO. Same here also, these also two similar charges, no? Then repulsive force will be acting, that is in this direction. Here also same charges, force will be acting in this direction. Means here it is F1 is force acting on charge Q due to Q1. Here it is force acting on Q due to Q2. Here it is force acting on charge Q due to Q3. So remember one thing, if you are finding the charge force acting on charge Q, then remaining charges will be considered, or it does not affect the force between Q1 and Q2. Means these charges, whatever the force acting F2, F3, this will not affect the force between Q and Q1. So because of already we know the vector sum of Coulomb's law, no? So we can finding the force F1, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q, Q1 by what is the distance here, it is there R1 square into R1 cap. So what is the direction? It is direction AO, in the direction of AO we can write. Here it is, let us coming the second force 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q, Q2 by what is the distance R2 square into R2 cap. R2 cap, what is unit vectors? So what is the direction? It is direction of, in the direction of BO. Here it is, in direction is there, no? So where is the displacement vector direction is there, or unit vector direction, in that direction only you can take the force also. Okay, so F3 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q, Q3 by R3 square into R3 cap, in the direction of, which direction it is acting? In the direction of CO. This is the total forces we have found. Then we have to find out the this one, no? Then F is equal to, so what is the statement we have given? Charge Q is the vector sum of electrical forces acting on it individually due to the other charges. That is F equal to F1 bar plus F2 bar plus F3 bar. Here it is, we have taken only three charges, no? For that F1 bar plus F2 bar and F3 bar. So where F1 is a force acting on charge due to the Q1 and so on like that. So if equal charges are symmetrically distributed, so what is the note I am saying here? It is note, if charges are equally distributed, okay, if charges are symmetrically distributed. Symmetrically, what is the meaning of symmetrically? Means distance is same, okay. Symmetrically distributed, distributed around given charge, around a given charge, then net force on the charge, net force on the charge is zero. Thank you for listening the class. If you like this video, share to your friends and subscribe my channel.